Hello students, in today's lecture we'll discuss the remaining MCQs from topic biological classification. Here the next MCQ is number 33. Which of the following shows coil RNA strand and capsomeres? Retrovirus, poliovirus, tobacco mosaic virus, and fourth one is measles virus. So in our book we have seen the structure of two viruses. One is bacteriophage and another one is the tobacco mosaic virus, which is a virus mainly affect the tobacco plant. So in the diagram of the tobacco mosaic virus, we have observed that there is a coil RNA strand, and around that coil RNA strand there are presence of the capsomeres, which are made up of the proteins. So the correct answer of this question is the tobacco mosaic virus. Retrovirus or poliovirus, measles virus, these are the some of the other type of virus which are not related to our question. Viruses have both DNA and RNA. DNA enclosed in a protein coat, prokaryotic nucleus, and the single chromosome. So here first option is incorrect one, because we have already discussed in one of the MCQ that virus has either DNA or RNA, but at a time it do not contain DNA as well as RNA. So first one is incorrect. Second one, DNA enclosed in a protein coat. This is the correct answer, because in the structure of virus we have seen that if the virus has genetic material DNA, it is not open, it is not naked one, it is always covered in a protein coat, and that's why the second answer is the correct one. Prokaryotic nucleus, it is not correct, because viruses are acellular. We cannot divide it into the prokaryotic or the other type eukaryotic. So prokaryotic nucleus is also incorrect, and the single chromosome, it is also incorrect. So correct answer of this question is DNA enclosed in a protein coat. Next, pick up the wrong statement. Here four statements are given. We have to choose the wrong statement from this. So first one is protista have photosynthetic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. Some fungi are edible. Nuclear membrane is present in Monera. Cell wall is absent in Animalia. So it is very easy question. We have to choose the incorrect or wrong statement from this, and if we think on it, then we can easily choose the incorrect one, because the first statement is that protista have photosynthetic and heterotrophic mode of nutrition. In kingdom protista, we have seen that this kingdom has groups like chrysophytes, dinoflagellates, then euglenoids, slime molds, and protozoa. Okay, in euglenoids, what we have seen that euglenoids is a group of protista which, when sunlight is present, carry out the photosynthesis, that is called as the autotrophic mode of nutrition. But when sunlight is not there, euglenoids acts as a heterotrophic. This is the one statement. So if we include the euglenoids, then we can see that it acts as a photosynthetic as well as heterotrophic nutrition. While other groups like protozoans, like dinoflagellates, they are also heterotrophic. So the first option state that protista is photosynthetic as well as heterotrophic. Means not it exclusively photosynthetic or not it exclusively heterotrophic. It has mixed mode of nutrition. So first answer or first option of this question is the correct one. Some fungi are edible. No doubt, majority of the fungi are pathogenic. They produce different type of diseases in plants, animal, even in the human being. But the some fungi like the mushrooms, morels, truffles are edible. So second option is also correct one. Nuclear membrane are present in Monera. This is incorrect statement because we have seen that Monera includes the prokaryotic organism. We have seen the example of it, that is the bacteria and the cyanobacteria or the blue-green algae. And in the prokaryotic cell, in the cell unit of life, we have also discussed that prokaryotic cell has the nucleus which is not bounded by nuclear membrane. The chromosome which is present inside this nucleus is always naked one. So here this statement, third one, is the incorrect or wrong statement. And the last is given that fourth option, cell wall is absent in Animalia. It is correct one because we have seen that kingdom Animalia is characterized by absence of the cell wall. Correct answer of this question is the third, nuclear membrane is present in Monera, because it is wrong statement. Cell wall is absent in Funaria, Mycoplasma, Aspergillus and the Nostoc. Now here we have to know the examples of it. That means here the examples are given, but we should know that which organisms is belong to which kingdom. For example, Funaria. Funaria is a example of the plant. Okay, if we discuss the next topic, plant kingdom, then you can easily understand that in the plant kingdom there are some kingdoms are there in which Funaria example is mentioned. So after completing the whole syllabus of 11th standard, you can easily give the answer of this question. So here you have to remember that Funaria is an example of the plant or kingdom planting Mycoplasma. We have seen that it is a smallest cell without any membrane, that means it is without cell wall, and it is an example of kingdom Monera. Nostoc is the example of the blue-green algae, and Aspergillus is the fungi. So clear cut here you can identify Mycoplasma is an example where cell wall is absent, because cell wall is present in blue-green algae, cell wall is present in bacteria, it is present in the plants, it is present in the fungi, but Mycoplasma is the organism which are smallest one, as well as it is anaerobic and it do not have any membrane, means cell wall is absent in the Mycoplasma. Next question. Which of the following are most suitable indicator of SO2 pollution in the environment? Now in the point lichen, we have seen that these lichen are the good indicator of the pollution. That means in non-polluted area lichen grows very well, while in polluted areas lichen do not grow. So here if we see the option of this question, then conifers, algae, fungi, lichen, these four options are there. Conifers means this is the example of the plants from the group Gymnosperms. Algae, it is also plant. Fungi, it is a separate kingdom, and the lichen. So clear cut answer of this question is lichen. Next question. In which group of organism The cell wall form two thin overlapping shells which fit together. Euglenoids, dinoflagellates, slime mold, and the chrysophytes. So, from the kingdom Protista, the four options are given here. And in first group, chrysophytes, we have seen that there is a group of organisms whose cell wall form the thin overlapping shells, which looks like the suitcase. साबणाच्या बॉक्ससारखं हे सेल वॉल्स आपल्याला पाहायला मिळतं स्ट्रक्चर. आणि हे एक्झाम्पल आपण पाहिलं होतं क्रायसोफाइट्समध्ये. सो करेक्ट आन्सर ऑफ इट इज दी क्रायसोफाइट. युग्लिनॉइड्समध्ये आपण युग्लिना बघितलं होतं. डिनोफ्लॅजेलेटमध्ये गोनोलेक्सचा स्टडी केला होता. आणि स्लाईम मोल्ड म्हणजे जे फंगासारखे ॲक्ट होतात, प्लाझ्मोडियम स्ट्रक्चर तयार करतात. पण या क्वेश्चनचं करेक्ट आन्सर आपल्याला सांगता येईल फोर्थ वन. Now here, the two columns are given. In one column, diseases are there. In other column, the pathogen of that particular diseases is given. So column 1 has the diseases, citrus canker, sleeping sickness, wheat rust, and herpes. And in column 2, pathogens are virus, bacteria, fungi and the protozoan. So here, if we concentrate on this table, then you can easily understand the disease and its pathogen. See here, 39 MCQ we are now discussing, and you can see that citrus canker is a bacterial disease. Then see sleeping sickness, it is due to the protozoa. Wheat rust is due to the fungi. And herpes is due to the virus. Again, citrus canker is a bacterial disease. Sleeping sickness is a protozoan disease. Wheat rust is a fungal disease. Herpes is a virus disease. And here, due to which the correct answer of this question is the second one. So answer is second one. Now next one. Virus that attack on bacteria are called. Here the name of that particular virus is asked. Bacteriophages, cyanophages, mycophages and coliphages. So we have seen that bacteriophages are the name of virus which are also called as the bacterial virus, which mainly attacks on the viruses. That's why they are called as the bacteriophages. So first answer is the correct one. In human intestine, which bacteria is commonly found? Entamoeba coli, rhinovirus, Escherichia coli, both 1 and 3. So in intestine of the human being, the bacteria E. coli, that is Escherichia coli, is present, which is generally harmless. It do not cause any disease or any harm to the human body, and it is present in the intestine. So third option is the correct one. Next statement is given in 42 MCQ. Statement A, neurospora is used in the study of biochemical genetics. Second one, morels and truffles are the poisonous mushroom. So in the kingdom fungi MCQ is there. We have seen that Neurospora is the most widely used fungi for the genetic studies, biochemical genetics. So first statement is correct one, but morels and truffles are not a poisonous mushroom, they are the edible mushroom. So second statement is incorrect. So correct answer from these options are statement A is correct and statement B is wrong. It is the third option. Next, which of the following fungus is used extensively in biochemical and genetic work? Again, just we have seen its answer. It is the Neurospora, because nuchal, rhizopus, yeast, all these are fungi, but they are not used for the genetic work. For genetic work, only Neurospora is used. Next MCQ. In plasmogamy, sperm and egg fuse together. Protoplasm of two haploid cells along with nuclei fuse together. Protoplasm of two haploid cells without nuclei fuse together. None of the above. Now, here, first we should know what is the plasmogamy, because this is the question from the kingdom fungi. And if you remember, recall the point that we have studied in our regular lecture, that is, in the sexual cycle of the fungi, we have studied there are three steps. One is fusion of protoplasm between two motile or the non-motile gametes are called plasmogamy. Fusion of two nuclei is called karyogamy. Meiosis in zygote results in haploid spore. So, if these three steps are considered in the sexual cycle of the fungi, the correct option of it is the third one, that is protoplasm of two haploid cell. Here what? Fusion of the protoplasm without nuclei fused together. And in second option, protoplasm of two haploid cell along with nuclei. So keep in mind, in the plasmogamy there is only fusion of the protoplasm, not the fusion of the nuclei. So correct answer of this question is third one, that is protoplasm of two haploid cells without nuclei fused together. Okay, and the last MCQ we will discuss, that is red tides is caused by. In the kingdom Protista, we have seen that the dinoflagellate is one of the group of Protista whose example is the gonolix, which are red in color and it causes the red tides. So here the correct answer of it is the dinoflagellates. So here overall about 45 MCQs we have discussed from the topic biological classification. This chapter is challenging one, because from first to last we have to read number of times this topic from the NCERT book, then only you can easily solve the MCQ from this topic. Okay, so it is very easy, interesting one. You have to only read it number of times, understand it very well. In this topic also you have to make some important charts, and that we will discuss here now. Here from this topic you have to make one chart like this, nutrition in bacteria, because in kingdom Monera we have seen that bacteria is one of its important example, nutrition in bacteria. For that you have to make a chart like some bacteria are autotrophic, some bacteria are heterotrophic. In autotrophic, there are two types again, which require light, that is called as photoautotroph, which require chemical, that is called as chemoautotroph. That means photoautotrophic bacteria prepare their food with the help of light, while chemoautotrophic bacteria prepare their food with the help of the chemicals. In the heterotrophic mode of nutrition of bacteria, there are again three types, saprophytic, symbiotic and the parasitic. Saprophytic means the bacteria which lives on the dead and decaying matter. Symbiotic means bacteria which shows symbiotic association with the other organism. And parasitic means the bacteria which lives inside the body of the other host and cause diseases there. Student, it is already discussed in our biological classification topic, but with this MCQ मी तुम्हाला असा सेपरेट चार्ट तुमच्या नोटबुकमध्ये करा म्हणून सांगत आहे की जेणेकरून तुम्हाला ते ते पॉईंट व्यवस्थित करतील. हे आपण नवीन काही डिस्कस करत नाही, जे डिस्कस केलेलं आहे तेच तुम्हाला मी एकदा परत सांगत आहे. असं तुम्ही लिहा असं मला सांगणं आहे तुम्हाला. नेक्स्ट पहा, आता स्क्रीनवर आपण एक चार्ट बघतो आहे पहा. प्रोटोजोआचा आपण किंगडम प्रोटोजोआ डिस्कस केला होता, बरोबर की नाही? पण जर तुम्ही असा चार्ट तयार केला तर हा किंगडम प्रोटोजोआ तुम्हाला आणखी व्यवस्थित समजेल. कसा पहा, इथं प्रोटोजोआचे चार ग्रुप्स केलेले आहेत पहा. अमीबॉइड प्रोटोजोन, फ्लॅजिलेटेड प्रोटोजोन, सिलिएटेड प्रोटोजोन आणि स्पोरोजोन्स. ठीक आहे, अमीबॉइड प्रोटोजोनचं एक्झाम्पल दिलेलं आहे, लोकोमोटिव्ह ऑर्गन त्याच्यामध्ये सुडोपोरिया, एक्झाम्पल अमीबा एंटामीबा. फ्लॅजिलेटेड प्रोटोजोन, एक्झाम्पल फ्लॅजेला ऑर नॉट एक्झाम्पल फ्लॅजेला, इट इज अ लोकोमोटिव्ह ऑर्गन, एक्झाम्पल ट्रेपॅनोसोमा. सिलिएटेड प्रोटोजोन, हियर द लोकोमोटिव्ह ऑर्गन सिलिया, एक्झाम्पल पॅरामोशियम. स्पोरोजोन, दे आर स्पोर लाईक स्टेज, हॅविंग द स्पोर लाईक स्टेज, एक्झाम्पल प्लाझ्मोडियम. सो अशा प्रकारे जर तुम्ही चार्ट तयार केला प्रोटोजोनचा तर व्हेरी इझी यू कॅन अंडरस्टँड द ग्रुप प्रोटोजोआ, आणि याच्यावरचे MCQ सुद्धा तुम्हाला व्यवस्थित समजतील. त्यासाठी आपण अशा प्रकारचा चार्ट तयार करू शकतो. या टॉपिकमध्ये बऱ्याच वेळा जंबल करणारा पॉईंट आहे तो म्हणजे किंगडम फंगाय. त्यामुळे किंगडम फंगायचा पण असा आपण सेपरेट चार्ट केला तर आपल्याला व्यवस्थित तो फंगाय किंगडम समजू शकेल. त्यासाठी काय करायचं आहे पहा, नोटबुकमध्ये रिप्रोडक्शन इन फंगायमध्ये आपल्या तीन टाईप्स लिहायचे आहेत, व्हेजिटेटिव्ह रिप्रोडक्शन, असेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन आणि सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन. व्हेजिटेटिव्ह रिप्रोडक्शन्स आर ऑफ थ्री टाईप्स, फ्रॅगमेंटेशन, फिशन, बडिंग. असेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शन, कोनेरिया, स्पोरॅन्जिओस्पोअर, झूस्पोअर. आणि सेक्शुअल रिप्रोडक्शनमध्ये आपल्याला घ्यायचं आहे ऊस्पोअर, अस्कोस्पोअर आणि बेसिडिओस्पोअर. तर हे आपण ऑलरेडी शिकवलेलं आहे, फक्त चार्ट कसा करायचा हे मी तुम्हाला सांगत आहे. तर या पद्धतीने आपण फंगायचा चार्ट तयार करू शकतो. आता पहा, जो लास्ट पॉईंट आपण या टॉपिकमध्ये बघितला होता तो म्हणजे लायकेन्स. लायकेन्सचा चार्ट तुम्ही असा तयार करू शकता, त्यामुळे लायकेन्स व्यवस्थित लक्षात राहील. लायकेन्स SO2 पोल्युशन इंडिकेटर, त्याच्यामध्ये लायकेन्स दोन ऑर्गॅनिझमबरोबर असोसिएशन दाखवू शकतं. आल्गीबरोबर दाखवलं त्याला म्हणणार आपण फायकोबायोन, आणि फंगायबरोबर दाखवलं त्याला म्हणणार आहे मायकोबायोन. ओके, आल्गी बरोबर असोसिएशन दाखवल्यानंतर त्याला आपण हेटरोट्रॉपिक आल्गी म्हणणार आहोत किंवा हेटरोट्रॉपिक लायकेन्स म्हणणार आहोत. फंगायबरोबर असोसिएशन दाखवलं तर आपण त्याला आल्गीबरोबर असोसिएशन दाखवलं तर त्याला आपण ॲटोट्रॉपिक म्हणणार आहोत, कारण आल्गी आर द प्लांट्स अँड दे कॅन प्रिपेअर देअर फूड. सो लायकेन्स आर ऑल्सो ॲटोट्रॉपिक. बट वेन लायकेन्स शोज असोसिएशन विथ फंगाय दॅट वी ऑलरेडी गिवन नेम मायकोबायोन, देन दॅट आल्गी आर हेटरोट्रॉपिक बिकॉज फंगाय आर नॉट ॲटोट्रॉपिक. सॉरी, द फंगाय विथ असोसिएशन ऑफ आल्गी prepare their food because algae are autotrophic, but the lichen with fungi shows association, they are heterotrophic, that's why they cannot prepare food, and so such a lichen with this fungi absorb mineral, nutrient, H2O
and provide shelter to the like. So the students who had studied this lichen very well, they can easily understand this type of chart. So with this MCQ in today's lecture, we have discussed the four type of chart that you have to make in your notebook, due to which you can easily understand some important point from this topic. Okay, from the next lecture we'll start the new topic from the bio 1. So study the topic very carefully, then you can easily solve the MCQ. Thank you.